Hey y'all, Mary Kennedy here from Kennedy Fan 5. I wanted to show you a mini Google Forms assessment that I made. Mini as in it's 5 questions, just like the majority of the ones that I've made. So it's great for a little ticket out the door or, you know, a homework check or something. But this is, there are actually 2 that I'm going to show you, and they're based on characteristics of quadratic functions. So there's 1 for standard form, 1 for vertex form. And I just wanted to share with you how I sort of set up the problems so that if you want to make one for yourself, you're welcome to copy my ideas and, you know, make your own for your classroom. Or if you are like, I don't have time for that, then I will put a link for where you can purchase mine. And I really appreciate it if you decide to do that. So this one just looks at vertex, axis symmetry, opening up or down, and min or max. And so what I did was I set these up as they have to look at the function. This one, this is the vertex form, and they have to choose the 2 right answers. So they're going to check 2 boxes. Let me show you the student version. So it looks like this. So, you know, if they think these are the 2 answers, then that's what they would pick. And then they move on to the next one. And so, you know, it just works like that. And I hope you're noticing that I'm not just saying, what's the vertex of this function? I think that this is a better, not every single time, but this is one really good way to assess this, because they can't just be like, oh, it opens up, easy, done, you know, takes me less than a second to figure that out and I move on. This makes them have to look at it a little bit farther. Okay, yeah, it opens up, but, you know, what's my axis of symmetry? Or, you know, do I need my vertex? All of those things that they're having to think through, right? So I think that's a useful way of doing this. I tried to make it very strategic. So, like, I'm assessing the same number, roughly the same number of vertex questions as axis of symmetry and min and max, you know, that kind of thing. I did want to show you a couple of things at the top. I have this instruction because, you know, I felt like it might be important. This is in my graphing quadratics unit. So I'm saying sketch the graph, and that's what they would either upload or turn in. But if you are not needing them to do that, if that's not what you need, then just hit the delete button, that little trash can, and, you know, that just goes away. If you're making your own, obviously you'll make your directions your own. And I also wanted to show you the upload your work button here. It's a file upload, and you can change all of those settings and, you know, make it very much your own, including hitting the trash can and just not even have that if that's not something you need for your classroom. And so I'll put a link to the settings video that shows you like how all of these are set up. This is the standard form one, and it's very much the same way, except the 5 questions are in standard form, obviously. But it works, you know, very much in the same manner. So here is the student version, just so you can kind of see. So they would just check whatever they think is the right answer, and I'm just checking randomly. So, all right. So that's that. I hope it helps. Thanks for watching.